Welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining us today on the seminar. I am Marie Dupria, one of the Athletes and Coaches Commission members, and with me...
Steve Robinson of the Referees Commission from the USA. I'm so happy to be here.
Okay, guys, we are going to take you through the general competition rules and also highlight some very important issues and some of the recent rule clarifications for you. Okay, let's start.
For the values, we provide high quality competition in the WUKF. We are together as one team. We work in the spirit of friendship and cooperation. We believe in respect and fairness. We are a democratic, nonprofit, profit-making organization. We support the Confederation strategy, and we support clean sport.
Thank you, Steve. Let's talk about the Coaches Education Program. By now, you guys would have seen on social media that the Athletes and Coaches Commission have embarked on this fantastic Coaches Education Program for all our coaches. The reason for this is we want to have our coaches who's going to coach at world, European, and continental championship levels to have a high level of competency and professionality. And just like the referees, we want our coaches to take part in the education program and pass a test like they do. This is a layer of what the program is going to entail. For now, the program is going to be phased in with the eye on Scotland in July this year. All we are going to require of coaches is to do the seminar, the webinar, and pass the test with 80%. So the main aim is going to get coaches to qualify for the EQF 5 level. Now, this education program of ours is accredited with Euro Ethics, and you will have a certified EQF level diploma that will be supplied to you. As we phase it in, coaches will be informed when that starts so that you can start doing the next EQF levels and when the other education modules will be ready. Okay, so let's start with the rules summary for coaches. Steve.
Yep. Thank you, Marie. So as you guys know, my recommendation is always go to the website, download the rules and study them thoroughly, read them from the beginning to the end, multiple times, not just getting on a plane and going to the World Championships. Okay. Let's talk about some administrative and other rules. The match area size for Kumite would be 8 by 8 meters square for Ippon and Sambon. 6 by 6 meters square for Nihon. 1 meter safety space around the tatami is required. For kata, the size of the area should be large enough so that the participants are able to do the kata safely. No disqualification if a competitor goes off the tatami during a kata performance. Let's look at the other stuff. All karateka, including competitors, coaches, etc., must follow the karate do ideas of good character, sincerity, effort, etiquette, and self-control. Coaches and competitors are not permitted to loiter around the tatami area, the jury table area, speak to or distract or interfere with the work of the jury table officials. Coaches are not permitted to accompany a kata competitor onto the tatami. Exception competitors with disabilities as per the inclusive karate rules. Okay, let's look at the competitors. They can compete only in their own age categories of age, height, weight, belt, etc., with the exceptions of kata teams. A junior cannot compete in a senior category. Exceptions. Veterans can choose to compete in either the senior or the veteran age category, but not both. They are not allowed to mix individual or team age categories. For example, veteran individual kumite and senior sambo and team kumite. Veterans can compete in an individual veterans Ippon event and in a veterans sambo team event. Veterans competitors can referee after their own veterans competition has finished. Competitors can also enter an individual open category, kata and kumite. Compete in either Ippon or sambo, but not both. Compete in either general or inclusive categories, but not both. The uniform. The WKF logo should be on the gi jacket at the bottom right. You're not allowed to wear anything that has WKF labels on it. If you do have it, that has to be covered over with a WKF sticker or your organization sticker. To 15 centimeters across your back. When you wear your competition number, it could be on the on your back or the bottom of your gi jacket. Your karate gi, we're allowed to have stripes or embroidery on your karate gi now. Shoulders are allowed. You need a clean white karate gi jacket and pants, with exception in kabuto categories. Competitors can, I already talked about, can wear their number on their back or their bottom of their jacket. It's not compulsory to have it in one place or another, and you won't be disqualified if the number falls off. If requested, the competitor and or the coach must be able to show it before the category or the pool starts. Let's talk about the length of the gis for kata. Sleeves must reach halfway down the forearm and must not extend past the bend in the wrist. Jackets must cover the hips but not reach down to your knees. Your belt must one tie be 15 to 30 centimeters in length, but it must not reach the knees. The pants must cover 2/3 of the shin and must not reach the ankle bone. Muslim women may use a white scarf or a chador. Female competitors can wear a plain white t-shirt underneath their jacket. Kata, wear a belt of your own grade. When flags are used, you wear a red or a white belt, depending on what side you're on. The sleeves of the trousers must not be rolled up. No other World Karate body badges or belt, pants, jacket, or equipment is allowed. If you're in appropriate dress and the referee sees that you have a WKF logo or any other logo that is not allowed, you have 2 minutes to change out of that uniform. If the referee sees it when the competitor is already on the tatami and the round has already started and it's too late to fix it, the competitor will be disqualified. This goes for Kimite too. You have 2 minutes to fix your uniform or change out of your uniform. After 2 minutes, the competitor has not been able to change his uniform, the decision of the referee would be Kikin, which is renunciation disqualification for this competitor. If the referee sees something after he or she has hijimated the match or began the match, the competitor will then be disqualified. The competitor coach is responsible for ensuring that the competitor is appropriate dress for the competition. No disqualification will take longer than 2 minutes when replacing or repairing damaged equipment uniform. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. Okay, let's quickly look at the coaches' uniforms. Been allowed the additional minute, same as the competitors. So coaches, you have 2 minutes to change into appropriate dress if something is wrong. Remember, if you cannot fix on your uniform, you can be asked to leave the area. Please make sure it is forbidden for a coach to wear his her karate gi. Even if you've got a tracksuit jacket over that karate gi, you're not allowed to have your tracksuit jacket around your hips. You're not allowed to have shorts or backpacks or cameras or any other badges and phones with you when you coach. Make sure you wear a national tracksuit or trousers and a national polo or golf shirt, and that you are professionally and neatly dressed. You are, for example, allowed to keep your draw sheet, your notepad, and pen and pencil with you while you're coaching, as you make notes of the scoring and so forth. Again, please remember, we are not allowed to assist the competitors to wear, adjust, get dressed, any of their equipment or clothes. But if the referees give you permission, you may assist the children. So please ask them if you've got kids on the floor and they are struggling. Ask the referees if you can help and assist them. If they say yes, please go ahead and assist them. Let's look at equipment. Okay, again, as Steve mentioned earlier, guys, please make sure that you download your rules. Now, our equipment articles that you have to make sure that you know is Article 4, 14.2, and Article 5 of the rules. Let's quickly run through them. You've got your mitts, which is white or red. No blue equipment, please. None. We've got our gum shields, transparent or clear. Groin protectors. We've got chest protectors for the females. And then we've got body protectors for kids and head guards for children. Again, just please bear in mind, no other World Karate logos on equipment. So not just on your pants or on your gi jacket, but on your mitts. Check that it doesn't say, for example, WKF. If it does, cover it with the supplied WUKF stickers or What I sometimes do is I just grab a black permanent marker and you just cover that logo. Please don't cover it with tape that can come off and get stuck in somebody's eye that can cause damage. Next up, let's look at equipment, compulsory and allowed. Under compulsory equipment, mitts are required for neon, sunbon, and ipon. In ipon, there are special WUKF ipon mitts, but you can also use similar models like the white traditional flat material mitts. Then we've got gum shields required for, or gum shields are compulsory for sunbon and ipon. Groin protectors are compulsory for males, neon, sunbon, and ipon. Chest protectors for females, sunbon, and ipon. Body protectors for children, neon, the protectors that cover the torso. Helmets and head guards are compulsory for children, neon. And then white instep protectors for neon and sunbon. If you're AKA, you can wear a red instep protector. Allowed equipment. Sport glasses, if they are approved by the doctor of the competition, or contact lenses can be worn at unrisk during kata and kumite. Gum shields are allowed for neon, and shin protectors are allowed for neon and sunbon. White or red? Red if you are the AKA competitor. Let's look at the forbidden and special equipment. No spectacles, glass or hard plastic for kumite, and no shin or instep protectors for ipon events. None, not even white ones. No blue equipment. Let's look at the medical and special items. Coaches, please, you have to inform the competition doctor about any medical item, like a pacemaker, a surveillance device, contact lenses that your competitor wears, so that you can get approval for it. If the referee discovers it and it was not authorized by the doctor, your competitor may be disqualified. And all you need to do is you need written approval from the competition doctor for these items, but then also to wear your special glasses or any special item. Please look at this Article 5. It gives you a very good explanation of what the process is. But in general terms, very quickly, if your competitor, for example, is wearing strapping on their ankle, they're using the kinetic strapping and it's not a hard brace, all you need to do is you go to the competition doctor, you show it to him, he or she will examine it, make sure that it is compliant, there's nothing hard on it, nothing that can injure the other competitor, and they will sign off on the ID badge of your competitor. Make sure you have that sign off, because if you do not have that and they have to start the match, your competitor may have a problem. Let's look at nails, metallic objects, hair, and so forth. Make sure the finger and toenails are short. You do not want to be looking for a nail clipper before your match starts. No metallic objects or false eyelashes. Ask the female competitors to make sure that these are not in their hair or on their eyes. All hair must be clean and cut or tied up so that it doesn't obstruct their performance and get in their eyes. You can wear discreet hair clips that is not metallic during kata, but not during kumite. And no Japanese headbands, amulets, or wristbands. All bandages or supports must be approved, as I said before, by the competition's doctor.
Let's look at the kumite for individuals, for sambon. It's 13 years and up, individuals. They can do individual, team, and team rotation. For nihon, it's 12-year-old and under. They can do individual and team rotation. For ipon, for 13 years and up, they can do individual, team, and team rotation. So let's look at the bottom left-hand corner of this slide. Competitors must choose ipon or sambon. Veterans can choose to compete in either the senior or the veteran age categories. Veterans can't mix individual or team age categories, veterans individual and senior team events. Veterans can compete in an individual veterans ipon event and in a veterans sambon team event. Kumite competitors must have their weight or height checked on the day of the registration. Competitors' ID badge must be stamped as having their weight or height checked. When you come to the tatami, the coaches sit on the opposite side of the jury table, facing the jury table. Kumite teams can have three competitors from the same age category, or can use one or two competitors from the previous younger age category. Competitors and coaches' badges must be given to the referees before a round starts. Remember to collect it after the round because you're going to need that for further competition.
Let's look at the scoring areas and techniques. Most of you, I know this, but just to remind all of us, let's look at the image first. Image there on the green side, that is what is allowed. So you can score to the head, you can score to the neck, you can score to the chest, abdomen, side, and back. You are not allowed to score to the throat, that's the front and side. Nothing on the shoulders, none on the limbs, that's your arms and your legs. You're not allowed to target the groin, any of your joints, that's elbow, hip, knee, ankle. You're not allowed to target the shins or the instep on the top of the foot. Now, part of this in terms of the scoring area and techniques is you will not, for example, get a point if an attack, even if it's effective, is delivered after the timeout bell is run. You will not get a point if a technique is delivered outside the match area. As we all know, that's jogger. You will also not get a point if a scoring technique of the same value is delivered simultaneously, if it's ouch. So if the one Aka and Shiro both deliver a fantastic gyakuzuki, it will not be counted because it will be ouch. You will, however, you can be awarded a point for an effective technique that is delivered simultaneously as the timeout bell. However, if a competitor delivering a technique was within the boundary of the match area, the point at which yame is called is helpful in determining if joga has occurred. Kumite, neon individual. If you look at the table, you'll see that there is the first column is the category column. You've got age, you've got belt, and then height for male and females. And the last column is notes. Our first category is children A, that's 6 to 8 year olds. Children B is 9 year olds. Children C and D is 10 year olds. Children E and F is 11 year olds. And children G and H is 12 year olds. The belt categories for all our children's categories will be all belts, white to black. Now let's look at the height divisions. For the 6 to 8 year olds and 9 year olds, it is open height. Our 10 year olds, the divisions will be under 1.45 meters. And over 1.45 meters for males and females. For 11-year-olds, it'll be under 1.50 meters and over 1.50 meters for male and females. 12-year-olds, you have under 1.55 meters and over 1.55 meters for male and females. Let's look at the notes column. In summary, the neon individual kumite category to win, you need 4 wazari or 2 ippon. They will use a mirror system to judge. The match duration will be 1 minute and 30 seconds, and they will use effective time. In the case of a tie, judges have to call hantai, and they've got to decide on nukach, a winner. No hikiwaki, no interesting. The warnings will be atanai, which will be 3, and kinchi, of which there are 4, as per Article 28. The next summary is for the Sanbon format. This is for our mini cadets and upwards. So let's look at the table again. We've got our categories, which is our mini cadets, our cadets B, our cadets A, juniors, seniors, and veterans. If we look at the ages, mini cadets is our 13-year-olds. I'm going to go down the row now, so please follow with me. So mini cadets, that's your 13-year-olds. Their division is, or their category is all belts. They have weight divisions. So you have under 45, under 55, under 65, and over 65 for males, and under 50, under 55, under 60, and over 60 for females. The match duration is 2 minutes. The next group is cadets B. That's your 14 to 15 year olds. It will be all belts. Weights is for males is under 55, under 65, under 75, and over 75. For females, it will be under 50, under 55, under 60, and over 60. Match duration will be 2 minutes. Cadets A, 16 and 17-year-olds, all belts, weight, under 55, under 65, under 75, and over 75. For females, under 50, under 55, under 60, and over 60. Match duration will be 2 minutes. Our juniors, that's our 18 to 20-year-olds, all belts, weight for males, under 65, under 75, under 85, and over 85. Weight for females, under 55, under 60, under 65, and over 65. Please note, their match duration is 3 minutes. Seniors, that is our 21 to 35-year-olds, all belts, weights for males, 60, under 65, under 75, under 85, and over 85. Weight for females, under 55, under 60, under 65, and over 65. Again, please note, their match duration is 3 minutes. Then our last group is our veterans, that are 36-year-olds and upwards. It'll be all belts, and the weight will be open, so there's no weight divisions. Their match duration is 2 minutes, like your cadets. Let's look at the notes column. To win, you need 6 wazari or 3 ipon. They will use a mirror system. It will be effective stoppage time. In a tie situation, when they call hantai, they can either go nukach and choose a winner, or they can say hikiwaki. And then if it goes to hikiwaki, there's an inchusen, which is a 1 minute extra time that they can fight. The warnings will be teatanais and fokinshi. Just a little side note, in the event of a tie, ipon should be considered as a criteria for deciding the winner. Please go and look at Article 30 to 32 so that you can make sure that you are aware of all the judging rules relating to this format. Our next category is ipon, individual. Let's look at our table. Okay, mini cadets, 13 years. And it'll be an all belt division. Here we are dividing them according to height. Males is under 65 meters and over 65. For females, it's under 155 and over 155. Then we've got our cadets A, our cadets B, which is our 14 to 15 year olds. Our cadets A, which is 16 to 17 year olds, and our juniors, which is 18 to 20 year olds. They will all three of these age categories will have an all belts division, and it will be open height and weight. No differentiation between these. We've got our seniors. That's 21 to 35 year olds. And there is an all belts division. And there will be a weight separation under 70 and over 70. But the, for women, it is open. So only the male competitors have got a weight separation. Our veteran section, we've got a 36 to a 40 year old group. And we've got 41 plus. It'll be all belts, no weight restrictions, and no height restrictions. Let's look at the last column, the notes column. You need 2 wazari or 1 ipon. They will use a flag system. There will be a central referee with 4 corner judges. The match duration is 2 minutes. It will be running time, which means the clock will only stop when the referee requests time. In a tie situation, it will call for hantai. Then they can either go nukach and select the winner, or they can go saishion, which is a new match. The warnings will be different to Sanbon and Neon. Please make sure you know this. Atanai, you will have Chogai, and you will have Mubobi. And then a little side note, please, again, make sure you know the rules. If there was a Sai Shihai, there cannot be another draw. So look at Article 51 to Article 55 and make sure that you know that. Steve, please take us through the Ippon and Wazari.
Okay, let's look at Ippon and Wazari for Nihons. For individual, for Nihon, a point is awarded when an exact, decisive, and power technique is delivered to the scoring year with the following criteria. Good form, technique, synchronization, position, and balance, strong vigor, with kime and good kiai, good attitude, zanchin, proper timing, and correct distance. Let's look at some of the examples of effective technique delivered under the following conditions shall be considered for an Ippon. When attack is delivered with perfect timing, an opponent is started to move towards the attacker. When attack is delivered immediately as the opponent was unbalanced by the attacker. When a combination of successive and effective techniques is used. Combined techniques that would have merit a wazari will be elevated to an Ippon. When an opponent has lost the fighting spirit and turned their back to the attacker and the attacker scores with a valid technique. Effective attacks delivered on the undefended parts of the opponent. A wazari is awarded for a technique almost comparable to that needed for to score for an ippon. The referee panel must look for an ippon in the first instance and only award a wazari in the second instance. For Wazari and Ipemu, balance must be kept for an effective kick. No points for kicking while jumping on one leg. All right, let's look at Kimite Ipon and Wazari for Sambo. For individual, a point is awarded when an exact, decisive, and powerful technique is delivered to a scoring error with the following criteria. Good form, technique, synchronization, position, and balance is kept. Strong vigor, kime and a strong kiai. Good attitude, zanshin, proper timing, and correct distance. In Shobu Sambon, a wazari would be given for all techniques. An ippon can only be given for a control kick to the head, jodangiri, or a safe takedown followed by a scoring technique for 3 seconds while the competitor is on the floor, or a break for balance immediately followed by a scoring technique. The maximum point for any punch or chudan kick would be a wazari. A wazari and ippon balance must be kept for an effective kick. No points for kicking while jumping on one leg. Let's look at the warnings and penalties for Sambon and Nihon. Excessive contact. Prohibited scoring areas are throat, shoulders, limbs, joints, hip, knee, elbow, insteps, shins, and groin. Open hand to the face, knee, elbows, and headbutts are not allowed. Jumping techniques prohibited. Dangerous leg and foot sweeps and throws. Must assist with a fall and throw or a takedown. Uncontrollable techniques like heel kicks. The number of warnings are, in the first instance, would be an Atenai. The final will be an Atenai Chui, and a disqualification will be Atenai Hansoku. Chui or Hansoku can be imposed directly depending on the severity and if the majority of the referee panel agrees, and after the consultation with the doctor. Warnings and penalties for Sambo and Nihon. This is a Kinchi warnings. Time wasting and consistently refusing to fight, running away, repeated interruption by clinching or unnecessary body contact against the opponent. Repeat grabbing and holding. Exaggerated actions and reactions, unsporting behavior like faking injuries. Behavior that brings karate into disrepute by competitor, coach, managers, parents, etc. Disrespectful and unnecessary actions, like throwing your gloves down, refusing to participate in a bout, disagreeing with the referee, etc. Show lack of regard for one's own safety by having your back turned toward the opponent. Touching the floor outside the match area, unless pushed. Grabbing, unless immediately followed by a technique. Uncontrolled and dangerous attacks such as hook punches and or kicking through the opponent. No kinchi will be awarded if the control technique misses the head or avoiding the attack. The number of kinchis are kinchi, kinchi knee, kinchi chui, and kinchi hansoku. Warnings and penalties for individual nihon. Forbidden contact and techniques, excessive contact to the face, helmet, or chest. If there is a body contact and then an obvious marking, the referee must immediately punish the offender with a warning or penalty. Technique can push or move back the head of the opponent. Grabbing or grappling or dangerous throws. Light touch to the helmet is allowed. Article 48.3, Naga techniques, Ashpadai, etc. has been deleted from the rules. Children now can do safe takedowns followed by scoring techniques within 3 seconds while the competitor is on the floor, as per Article 25.3. Warnings for ippons. Let's look at the Atenais. Same thing, excessive contact, prohibited scoring, open hand techniques to the face, elbow techniques, headbutts are not allowed, jumping techniques are not allowed, dangerous leg or foot sweeps and throws. You must assist. If you're going to take someone down, you have to take them down carefully. Uncontrollable attacks to like heel kicks or any kind of dangerous kicks in the knees or anything like that is not allowed. And the warning penalties go Atenai Chui and Atenai Hansoku. And once again, Hansoku can be imposed directly depending on the severity of the technique. In Ippon, we have Mabobis, and the same as before, time wasting, refusing to fight, running away will be considered a Mabobi. Repeating, grabbing, holding, etc. would be considered a Mabobi. Exaggerated actions and reactions. Behavior that brings karate in disrepute. for competitors, coaches, managers, anybody connected with the competitor. Disrespect and unnecessary action during the match. Showing lack of regard for one's own safety with your back turned towards your opponent. Grabbing unless followed up by a technique. Uncontrollable attacks which exceed pass or over the target. Okay, the number of warnings for Mobobis are in Ippon, Mobobi, Mobobi Chui, and Mobobi Hansoku. For Ippon, you will have 3 jo guys, not 4 jo guys. Touching the floor outside a match area with any part of your body will be considered a jo guy. Going out deliberately or to avoid a technique is a jo guy. If you deliver an unsuccessful technique and then exit it immediately, that would be considered a jogai too. That's in Article 55.3 for examples of jogai. Once again, right, I recommend you download the rules and study them. No warning penalties if the competitor is pushed outside the match area. And the number of warnings go in order of jogai, jogai chui for the final warning, and then disqualification would be jogai hansoku. Warnings and penalties for sambo, nihon, and ippon for shikaku. Now, once again, we have to get a confirmation from the referee commission to shikaku someone. Do not obey the orders of the referee. Competitors become aggressive. Commits an act which harms and prestige the honor of or violating the rules and spirit of karate do. Competitor or coach, managers, parents, etc. make obscene or offensive gestures, makes threats, or give verbal abuse to the officials or other competitors. Referee believes that the competitor has acted maliciously, and once before shikaku can be imposed, the referee, the time manager, and the referees commission must be in agreement. The competitor or the team who receives shikaku in the semifinal or finals will not receive a medal. Shikaku is different from a hansoku disqualification. Shikaku, you will have to leave the competition area and have some additional penalties may be imposed at a later date. Hansoku, you're disqualified from the round.
Guys, let's look at team categories. This is regular kumite team categories. This is only for your sanbon and your ippon formats. So the age categories that can compete in this format is your cadets, B, A, juniors, and seniors. That's from 15-year-olds up to 35-year-olds. Let's look at the table. So on all four of these age groups, you have an all belts division. So there's no belt categories. Everybody competes white to black. The weight is open for both male and female. So no divisions there. Let's look at the match durations. So for the cadets from 14 to 15 and 16 to 17 year olds, it's a 2-minute fight. For juniors and seniors, it's a 3-minute fight. Let's look at the notes column. If you're doing team sanbon, remember, these are 3 individual matches, and they will be refereed and scored according to the sanbon or then the ippon rules for individual matches. So if it's sanbon team match, they will use effective time. They will use the mirror system. If there's a tie, they can go hikiwaki, and you can do an extra match. And if there's still a tie, then they can go to inchusen, which is another minute. Your warnings will be your atanais and your kinshis, as with the individual matches. If it's the ippon format, team kumite, they will use effective time. In a tie, they will be, remember, on the floor, they will use the central referee with corner referees. So it will be the flag system. If there's a tie, they will call hantai. They can then decide nukach, or they can go saishian. The warnings will be according to the individual ippon format. It will be atanai, jogai, and mobobi. One of the new clarifications that Steve mentioned earlier is that we can now pull up competitors from the previous age group. So please keep this in mind now. If you have, for instance, a 16-year-old, so a cadet A competitor, you are allowed to pull that cadet A competitor into a junior team. So make sure that you are now aware of this, like with kata, because we could do this with kata. We can now do this in kumite teams as well.
Yeah, so as Marie mentioned, it's cadet A only. You cannot pull up a cadet B, because that's 2 age groups below. So the only cadets A, which are 16 and 17 year olds, can go up into the junior division.
Let's look at team, individual team matches. Sanmon team and Ippon team matches. Before the match start, a team representative, that's usually the coach, or it can be also the team captain, should hand the fighting order list to the jury table. So that is, look at the little images there. So in round one, competitor number one to 1001 and 1002 is going to fight in that order. This one is going to go up, and then this one, and then this one. In round two, you can change your order if you want to in the next round, but you have to inform your table officials of that. Every time you fight, you need to submit your fighting order. And then you've got your three team members, and you can have one reserve. So let's look at the fighting order. The order can be changed for each round. Once you have handed in your list, you cannot change that order. If you use your reserve person or competitor, that is a change in the fighting order. So if you are in round one and your one competitor gets injured and you bring in your reserve in that round, that is a change in your order. And that can lead to your team being disqualified. Another example is if you've decided that they're going to fight in the following order, competitor A, B, and C, and that's the list you've given to the jury table. During the round, competitor A comes up first, and the second fight is competitor C. That is a change in the fighting order, and your team can be disqualified or will be disqualified. Let's look at the team members. There must be three competitors. If there are not three competitors at the start of the first round, the team will be kicking. You can have one reserve, and that person can be substituted for an injured competitor, or if the coach requires it, in the next round. The team can continue to fight if two members are injured. Now let's look at the rotational team categories. Okay, our first column there is our category groups. Again, this format is for 13-year-olds and up. We have our mini cadets, the 13-year-olds, the cadets Bs, 14 to 15, cadets A, 16 to 17, our juniors, 18 to 20, seniors, 21 to 35, and then our veterans is 36 years and up. It will be all belts categories, so no belt divisions, and there will be no weight divisions for male and females. It'll be open weights. The duration of the match is 6 minutes. Again, remember, we can now pull in competitor one or two competitors from a previous age group into our teams. So you can now, for example, have a 19-year-old, which is the junior, compete in a senior team, or with two seniors or two juniors with one senior. They just have to compete in the older age group. So you cannot have a senior come down and compete in a junior team. Let's look at the notes column. They will use the mirror system. There's no limit to points. So you don't need a specific number of points. You can score as many points as you like. They will use running time. When there's a tie, the referees look at the number of ippon. If there's still a tie, they will call hantai. Then they can go nukach, or they can go hikiwaki. If it's hikiwaki, you'll have a 2-minute interesting. That is a minute more than in the individual sanbon match. With running time, remember the clock stops only when the referee requests time. So coaches, please make sure that if something happens on the floor, let's say for instance an injury, that they stop the time so that the time does not keep on running. Warnings will be atanai and kinshi like for regular sanbon. Okay, let's quickly look at our team members for rotation. You have, the team must consist out of three competitors. You can have one reserve. It is not compulsory to have a reserve. So your reserve, you can substitute for an injured competitor or when the coach requires it. Each member must fight 15 seconds and at least once during the fight. A coach may make as many substitutions between the three team members as you like. Now, for me, rotational team format, it's almost like tag team. So you can tag in a member after the first 15 seconds that a new fighter is on the floor, whenever you like. You cannot make any changes or substitutions after Ratoshi Baraku. After the last 15 seconds of the match, you cannot make a change. You can try, but the change judge will not allow it. The winner of the rotational team format is the team who scored the most points during the 6 minutes, or if a team has an advantage of 6 points within the 6 minutes. So if team A comes up against team B and team A scores 6 points more than team B, even if not all of three of them have fought, they can be declared the winner. Disqualification in this format comes on two grounds. One, the round starts and there's not three competitors. So you do not have three competitors. You will get disqualified for each round, not for every new category, for each round. And the second instance is if somebody has not fought at the end of the match. So when the 6 minutes are finished and one of your fighters have not been on the floor, that whole team can get disqualified, even if they have more points. Then in the tie and interesting situations, the team who has the most ippon will win. Otherwise, they go to interesting if it's a tie. So if they do interesting, then the coach will choose one competitor of their team to fight in the extension of the match. The competitor may then be changed after the extension has begun. So you choose somebody to start that extension. And as the fight starts, you can substitute again. Let's just look at some administrative stuff in terms of this format. Coaches sits down next to the change judge. So if you look at the floor diagram that we've got there, you'll see your scoring table, your jury table at the bottom of your screen there. Right opposite that table is where your extra judge or your change judge sits. Now, next to that extra judge is your coaches. Your competitors will line up next to the coaches. So that's their starting positions and they must be ready. As you change a new competitor, that competitor runs onto the floor. When you change out a new competitor, the competitor returns to the side of the tatami. They do not return back to your side where you are sitting. So if all at the end of the day, when all your fighters have fought, you will have three competitors standing on the side of the tatami and nobody standing next to you. You have to make your substitution within 3 seconds. In exceptional circumstances and with the WUKF Referee Commission's permission, the team captain may make substitutions if there is no coach. Very quickly, how the change works. So your first fighter is on the floor, then look to the arrow that goes down. 15 seconds starts. So that fighter now has to fight for 15 seconds. 15 seconds has lapsed. Now you can make your first change. Remember, both coaches are allowed to make that change. So if the first fight starts after the first 15 seconds, either of the coaches can call for a change. So the coach shouts change. The coach that the change judge hears first will be validated. So make sure that you are heard by the judge. He will blow his whistle and he will lift his flag. So if you are on Aka's side, he will blow the whistle and he will lift the flag for Aka so that the referee knows that that's where the change has been called. Okay. Then the referee will call Yame. No change should happen before the referee has called Yame and has said change. Please tell your competitor and teach them they can only change when the referee says change. They will be used to you shouting change. And especially if they are not very experienced, they will run off when you shout change instead of when the referee shouts change. So make sure that they know that. The penalties your team can incur is if you don't change within 3 seconds and the team takes too long to get a new fighter on the floor, you can get a kinchi. If you substitute or change without the referee's command, you can get a kinchi. So if your fighter runs off the floor when you shout change and the referee has not called Yame and said change, you can get a kinchi. And then all your warnings and penalties, it applies to the whole team. So you can have the first fighter and that fighter can incur maybe an Atanai Chui. And that will then count for all the fighters that are still remaining. Okay. So let's look at rotational team for the neon format. Okay. Again, look at the table. We've got our only two children categories, category A and B. The age groups are for category A is 10 years and old and younger. And category B is 11 to 12 year olds. The belts will be all belts, white to black. The weight categories for male and females will be open. The match duration is 4 minutes. On the notes column, they use the mirror system. It'll be running time. And again, as in individual neon, when there's hantai, judges score for must go nukach. They must choose a winner. No hikiwaki, no interesting. Warnings again, as per Article 28, you can have 3 atanais or 4 kinshis. Very important, please go back to your rules and go and reread Articles 40, 43, and 44 for rotation team Sanborn. That those 3 articles will remain valid in neon rotation. They deal with the team members, how many you must have, the substitution procedure, and the penalties that you can get in team rotation. A winner for team rotation is decided by the team who scored the most points during the 4 minutes, or the team with an advantage of 4 points within the 4 minutes, even if not all members are fault. So if you team A fights team B and team A scores 4 points, team B has got 0 points, and they are 1 minute into the fight, and only fighter one has fault, they are automatically declared the winner. Just a reminder for everybody, in neon team rotation, it's still the same rules because all 3 of your fighters needs to fight unless it's an advantage of 4 points, and every fighter must fight at least 15 seconds. The rules regarding forbidden contact and techniques, which you will get in Article 48 of individual neon committee, will apply to rotation team neon. The criteria for scoring in neon rotation team is listed in Article 25. It's the same criteria for scoring as you would get in neon individual committee. Let's quickly look at the rotation for IPON. Let's look at the table. We've got our mini cadets and upwards. So your mini cadets, 13-year-olds, cadets B, 14 to 15, cadets A, 16 to 17, juniors, 18 to 20, seniors, 21 to 35, and veterans, 36 and up. All belt divisions, open weights, and the duration of the match is 4 minutes. Notes column. It'll be a flag system as for IPON individual. It'll be running time again. The clock will stop when the referee requests time. Make sure that it stops if it is requested. If there's a tie, they will look at the number of IPON. If there's still a tie and they call hantai, it'll be nukach or asaishian. The warnings is the same as in individual IPON, atanai, jogai, mabobi. We will use the Sanborn rules in IPON as well. That means that's for the number of team members that you need to have, your substitution, and deciding the winning team and penalties. So the rules are the same for IPON rotation as it is for Sanborn. The exception here, and this is what coaches need to be very, very clear on. In IPON rotation, if my competitor is scored by an IPON, so if the first fighter of team A scores an IPON against the first fighter of team B, the first fighter of team B will be eliminated for the remainder of the match. He is out of the match for that time. So you cannot change that person back in. Only competitor B and C of the team can then be substituted with each other. If there's a Saishai match, the competitor that has been scored an IPON against him or her can compete again in the Saishai match. Mm-hmm. The only other exception to in terms of the rules for this rotation is because it's IPON, all kinshi penalties is replaced with mubobi penalties.
Okay, let's look at kata. For general, veterans can compete only in one veteran kata category. Competitors must choose to compete in either a general or inclusive categories. Juniors can compete in senior categories. Veterans can choose to compete in either the senior or veteran age category, or not both. You compete in one kata style only and perform kata only from the style that has a kata list. Competitors must perform a kata from his or her own style that they were registered in, and the style must be written down on their ID badges. Procedure for kata. When you come into the ring, you must bow to the center referee, and the competitors must clearly announce the name of the kata. The center referee will clearly repeat the name of the kata to the athlete and the jury table. Your competitor must listen. Be sure the referee repeats the correct name of the kata back to you. The jury table must check if it is the correct kata before the kata is started. If the kata is not allowed, the center referee will tell the athlete it is not allowed, and they can announce a new kata. to avoid disqualification. This can only happen one time. Your main styles that we separate in are Shotokan, Wadaru, Goju-ryu, Shitaru, and Shurinryu. The other styles are all together: Uechi-ryu, Kyokushinkai, Shugokai, Sunkukai, Gosoku-ryu, and Budokan. The main style categories that do not have three competitors will be included in other style categories. Okay, let's look at the individual categories for kata. So if you look at the category A, B, C, D, and E, the ages are 6 to 8 for A, 9-year-olds for B, 10-year-olds for C, 11 for D, and 12 for E. The belt system is Q97. It's white and orange. And the rounds are Shite, round 1, Shite, round 2, Shite, round 3. They're the katas that are allowed to perform. And yes, you can repeat in this category. If you look at the next category, which is children A, B, C, D, and E, these are 6 to 8-year-olds, which is A, 9 for B, 10 for C, 11 for D, and 12 for E. The Q ranking is 6 to 4th Q. It's green, blue/purple. And the rounds are the first round is Shite, second round is Shite, third round is Sente, and you cannot repeat. You look at the next category, which is children's A, B, C, D, 6 to 8-year-olds for A, 9-year-olds for B, 10 for C, and 11 for D. The Q is third Q and Dan, which is brown and black belts. The rounds for the first round is Shite, second round Sente, third round Sente, and no, you cannot repeat. And the last category is children E, 12-year-olds. It's all styles. Okay, so it's all styles for all the categories. The Q is third dan. It's third Q to dan rankings, which are brown and black. And the rounds are Shite for the first round, Sente for the second, and Takui for the third. And no, you cannot repeat. No equals can't repeat a kata once it has been performed, not even in a tie situation. Individual categories for mini cadets, cadets B, and cadets A. For the ages 13-year-olds, it's Shotokan. The style blocks are Shotokan, Shitoryu, Shurinryu, Goju-ryu, Wadaru, and the other styles. And the belts are white to black. So for round one, they could do Shite or Sente. For round two, they can do Shite, Sente, or Takui. And the same thing for round three, Shite, Sente, and Takui. And like I mentioned before, you can't repeat the kata. Cadets B, which are 14 to 15-year-olds. The style blocks are Shotokan, Shitoryu, Shurinryu, Goju, Wado, and other styles. It's white to black belts. First round, you can do Shite or Sente. Second round, Shite, Sente, or Takui. And the third round, Shite, Sente, or Takui. And you can't repeat the kata. And then cadets A, 16 to 17-year-olds. The style blocks are Shotokan, Shitoryu, Shurinryu, Goju, Wado, Ryu, and other styles. And it's all belts, white to black. First round, Shite, Sente. Second round, Shite, Sente, and Takui. Third round, Shite, Sente, Takui. And you can't repeat. Even in a tie situation, you cannot repeat the kata once it has been performed. Okay, let's look at the individual categories for kata for juniors, seniors, and veterans. In the junior category, which is our 18 to 20-year-olds, the styles are Shotokan, Shitoryu, Shurinryu, Goju, Wadaru, and other styles. The belt rankings are all white to black. In the first round, you could do Shite and Sente. In the second round, you could do Shite, Sente, or Takui. In the third round, you could do Shite, Sente, or Takui. And no, you cannot repeat. In the senior divisions, which are 21-year-old to 35-year-olds, once again, the styles are Shotokan, Shitoryu, Shurinryu, Goju, Wado, and other styles. The ranking system is white to black belts. In the first round, Shite Sente. Third round, Shite Sente and Takui. Third round, Shite Sente and Takui. And you cannot repeat. In the veterans division, veterans A, which are 36 to 4-year-olds, veterans B, which is 41 to 45-year-olds, veteran C, 46 to 50-year-olds, veteran D, 51 to 60-year-olds, and veterans E, 61-year-old plus. That's all styles, all ranks, white to black. First round, Shite Sente. Second round, Shite Sente Takui. And the third round, Shite Sente Takui. And no, you cannot repeat. Once again, no Eagles can't repeat a kata once it has been performed, not even in a tie situation. And remember, veterans can choose to compete in either the senior or the veterans age category, not both. Just a little quick reminder there.
Thank you. Let's very quickly look at our kata teams. In all team kata must take the triangle formation. Competitor in front will announce the kata, and all three members can kiai. Now let's look at our table. Children division is 10 and under. The second one, children B, is 11 to 12 year olds. We've got our mini cadets, the 13 year olds, cadets B, 14 to 15 year olds. Cadets A, 16 and 17 year olds, juniors 18 to 20, seniors 21 to 35, and veterans 36 years and up. Now, all of these age categories, they are all styles. They are all belts. So white to black belts in each category. Their rounds, our children, two children groups do shitai kata in round one, shitai kata in round two, and then a sentai kata in round three. They are not allowed to repeat. Then from our mini cadets and upwards, so that means mini cadets, cadets B, A, juniors, seniors, and veterans. Round one, they can do a shitai or a sentai kata. Round two, they can do a shitai, sentai, or toku. And round three, they can do shitai, sentai, or toku kata. They are not allowed to repeat. Remember, our kata teams, you can pull one or two competitors from the previous age group. So you can have a 14-year-old compete in a cadets A team, which is, say, you have then a 14-year-old, a 16, and a 17-year-old. So you're allowed to do that. But they must compete in the oldest competitor's age group. Let's talk about kata rounds. Steve?
In round one, if you have 30 competitors or more, going into round two, we will take 18 competitors. At the end of round two, we will find six competitors to go on to the round three, and the top three will receive medals. If there's under 30 competitors, we will take the top 12 to the from the first round. And going to the second round, we take six competitors. And once again, we'll find the top three to receive medals in the final round. If there's 12 or less, there's no round one. That will go automatically to round two. We'll look for the top six competitors to go to round three, and the top three will receive medals with the best scores. If there's only one competitor, there's only one round, and that competitor will receive a medal. So let's look at the scoring ranges. For round one, it's 5.0, and it's a 20-point scale to 7.0. And round two, it's 6.0 to 8.0, once again, 20-point scale. Round three, it's 7.0 to 9.0. And scoring is based on a 20-point scale in the above ranges. Each of the ranges have four main criteria, which receive a numeric grade of 1 through 5 and added to the base for the final score. And I'll explain that in a couple minutes. Judges are to award points based on judging criteria. Let's look at the five criteria. Number one, unsatisfactory. Number two, satisfactory. Number three is good, four is very good, and number five is excellent. When disqualifying the score for all competitors, will be the lowest score of that round. So if it's in the first round, it'd be 5.0. If it's the second, 6.0. And if it's the last round, it's 7.0. When original five scores, the highest and lowest score is deleted and canceled and not used ever again. The total score of remaining three scores are calculated for the round result. So let's look at round one. So it's 6.8, 6.9, 7.0, 7.1, 7.1. 7.1 and 6.8 are eliminated, and you add up the minimum scores. In round two, same thing, you have five scores, the low and the high. Three main scores are added together. In round three, five scores again, the low and the high are thrown out, and the remaining scores are added together. The second and third round, the combined scores are added together, which is 23.9 and 24, which gives you a 47.9 total. If there is a tie in the second round, round one or two, add the lowest score in first of the remaining three scores. If there's still a tie, you add the highest score in of the three remaining scores. And if this tie still persists, the person will come out and flags will be used to determine the winner, red or white. They will use a red belt or white belt to determine the winner of the match. If all competitors who compete in the tie round are disqualified, each competitor must perform an opposed shite kata from their kata style. All right, let's look at the criteria of decision on basic performance. Number one criteria, create structure of technique. The first one is correct body geometry. That means that it's the shape of the form of the body. The correct body posture, the proper stance structure, the proper connection between stance and posture, the proper balance and stability in the structure of the stance, proper inbusun, that means that you're facing the direction that you started, and proper eye vector. Now, proper eye vector means the relationship between the eyes and the technique itself. Eye vector and power vector must travel virtually and parallel with each other, only to intersect at a point of infinity. And the ocular and the pelvic relationship must be connected. Let's look at number two, creating power. Expansion and contraction of the body, control of tension and contraction, proper execution and utilization of ki, proper breathing. Methods of creating power are body shifting, body rotation, lifting and dropping of the body, and body vibration. Number three, kime or transfer of power, synchronization, timing, and proper interval. And the other elements, your rhythm is there. Understanding the features of the kata is specific to the performance of the kata you're doing. Proper attitude and spirit, concentration, the degree of difficulty, rhythm, and the risk in the performance of the kata, and the budo and the fighting spirit attitude of the competitor. Okay, let's go back and look at these ranges. So once again, it's a 20-point scale range. So say competitor A comes up and you're looking at them and you judge them on all the criteria, these four criteria, and on each criteria, you give them a 3. So at the end, you can add the 3s up, which will be 3 for structure, which is 3 points, 3 for creating power, which is another 3 points, that's 6 points, right? 3 for kime, that's 9 points, and then 3 for the other elements, that's 12 points. So if you're looking at a scale of 6 to 8, that would be 7.2 you will give the performance to this competitor. Or you can subtract 12 from 8.0, which will be 7.2. So the scoring range, let's look at that. So 6.7 is unsatisfactory. 6.8 is satisfactory, 7.2 is good, 7.6 is very good, and 7.7 is excellent. For kata, let's look at the deductions and disqualifications. Let's look at the minus points first. A 0.1 deduction will be deducted for the following: a discernible pause or a slight imbalance, the absence of each ki. In team kata, if there is excessive breathing or slapping of the body. Okay, let's look at the disqualifications. For disqualifications, the score will be 5-0, 6-0, or 7-0, according to the round in all age categories. A competitor can be disqualified for the following: if a competitor stops for more than 5 seconds, if the competitor forgets or adds a technique, loses balance completely and falls, absence of all ki, no ki at all, if belt, trouser, or device, etc., but not the number, falls during the kata performance, if the competitor announces the kata, which is not allowed twice, that's per Article 66.4. You can't be disqualified if the competitor performs a nominated kata allowed in that round, but the table records the wrong kata. For example, in a sente kata round, if the competitor announces jion, but the table official records basadai, the performed kata must be scored and there will be no disqualification. The Tommy chief or the senator referee can call for shugo to disqualify or discuss an issue.
We're almost at the end of our seminar. Let's quickly look at the official protest procedure. Again, make sure you read Article 8 of the rules. It gives you in detail how this procedure works. If something happens, the coach announces to the tatami manager that you intend to protest, to officially protest. And you have to do that right after the match, before the next category or next match starts. Do not wait until the whole category is finished and then you want to lodge an official protest. Once you have indicated to the tatami manager that you want to lodge a protest, he will stop the whole round and inform the WUKF Referee Commission that an official protest is going to be lodged. The process will then start. Before you can protest, you've got to pay the protest fee, and at the moment it is still 200 euros. This amount is stated on the WUKF website, so please make sure that you always have a look at that to see if it's changed. If you successfully protest, your money will be returned. Okay, you will have to complete the protest sheet. You will give that to the tatami manager, and that will then be taken to the WUKF Refcom. They will have discussions, and the outcome, feedback on the outcome of the decision will be given to the coach by the tatami manager. Very important. Only the coach of the team or competitor involved may lodge an official protest to the tatami manager. A competitor is not allowed to protest. The parent is not allowed to protest. Another coach is not allowed to protest. And also note that when the category is finished and the medalists have been notified, we cannot appeal the decision. Steve, will you please take us through this?
Can protest a decision that might have violated rules or the match or of judging. There is an administrative error during the match, and you cannot protest a technical decision or a point called. Administrative errors can be solved quickly on the floor without an official protest, and that comes from the jury table. Coaches must provide evidence for the protest, but video proof regarding an instruction technical evaluation error is not acceptable, or evidence for the protest. Video proof is acceptable as evidence only for administrative errors and only if the incident is clearly visible. Notify the tatami manager when you want to make a protest. Notify the tatami manager of any administrative error as soon as it is detected. For example, wrong competitor called out or put through to the next round. Points given not being shown on a scoreboard. Wrong points shown on a scoreboard. Wrong calculations of points in kata. Wrong kumite format for age group. Wrong kata done for the round but allowed. Forget to stop the time. Wrong number of penalties given or shown. And if a kata judge gives, for example, 7-5 and in a round says 6-0.
Okay, coaches, so let's quickly look at the warnings and penalties that apply to us. Yes, we can be penalized for bad behavior against officials, but also against our own students and competitors. Which means please be aware of how you behave and how you behave against other competitors, other officials. Remember, we are all one team when we are on the floor. The decision to warn and penalize a coach will be taken by the referee panel and the tatami manager. To warn a coach, the tatami manager will mark, will take the coach's ID badge, and he or she will put an X on the back of the coach's badge to certify it with his or her signature. Now, if you look at the little image that we've got there, the penalty scale for us is 3 kinshis. So you will have kinshi, kinshi chui, and kinshi hansuku. In special situations, we can get a kinshi hansuku directly. After the third X on your coach's badge, you will not be allowed to act as a coach anymore in the competition at all. So if you get 3 X's on your badge on day one of a 4-day competition, that will be the last day of your competition. And the WUKF Referee Commission can also impose a suspension for a period of time from all competitions if the infringement was severe enough. Lastly, but not least, let's look at injuries and accidents. Again, if there was an injury, the doctor will be called. Look at that little image. I'm going to run from left to right and read it for you. So there was a fight. We have an injury. Competitor A gets injured very badly. They call the doctor. And the doctor will then decide, yes, that person can continue, or no, that person cannot continue the match. Depending on the doctor's decision, the competitor will be allowed to continue or not. The injury for the competitor must be recorded or written down on the injury form or sheet that is at the jury table if the competitor is allowed to continue in the fight or in the next match. Coaches and parents can not go onto the floor to assist with an injury. That is the doctor's or the medical personnel's job. Only the doctor or paramedic can decide whether or not they can continue. A parent cannot say, yes, no, that person is fine, you can fight. The competitor himself or herself cannot say, no, I'm fine, I don't mind my broken nose, I can fight. Only the doctor can decide that. If you filled in an injury sheet for your competitor, make sure that you check that the sheet has been submitted to the jury table, so that there's not a problem if your competitor is competing, if he's allowed to compete and then wants to compete in the next match. Okay, no point shall be awarded if the competitor injures the opponent, even if the injury is only very minor. So obviously we all have to make sure that we watch our contact. If a competitor causes excessive injury to another competitor, based on the doctor and the referee's report and the medical documents, the referee commission may impose additional penalties on that competitor. That could be a written warning, suspension of between 1 and 2 years from all WUKF international competitions, or the competitor can be banned from all committee competitions in WUKF events. And that is the last slide. Thank you very much. Steve, thank you for co-hosting the seminar with me.
It's been my pleasure. Thank you guys for having me. And I think Marie and I are a good team.
Yes, thank you so much. Thank you for spending this time with us. You guys are now welcome. Go and download the slides that we've taken you through. That will be made available to you. You're also now welcome to go and take the coaches exam to get your EQF qualification. If there are any questions, you can send it through to Mr. Soren Halstead, and see you guys at the World Championships. Thank you.
See you guys there. Look forward to seeing everyone.